once again, good afternoon, everyone. So for today, we will be discussing about an introduction regarding physical pharmacy and physical chemistry. So basically, class, our objectives for today would simply be to introduce you to physical pharmacy. Okay, discuss to you the concepts, some things that you have to remember, okay, regarding the topic, and what physical pharmacy is all about. And with that, let's start now with the introduction to physical pharmacy and physical chemistry. So first things first, class, why is it relevant to study physical pharmacy? So as you all know, class, pharmacy is an applied science. Okay, hindi lang naman tayo limited sa hard science. Of course, dyan din naman yung ating patient care setting, right? Wherein we practice pharmacy in the patient in the clinics or in a patient care setting. So basically, pinapractice natin ito either sa butika or sa hospital. Okay, pwede rin naman yun. Or if we are going to become pharmaceutical scientist, class, then obviously we will be practicing pharmacy in the manufacturing firms, in quality control, okay, and so on and so forth. So before class, top skin pharmacy are descriptive and empiric, most often than not. Okay, but now, class, it's quantitative and theoretic, meaning this time, class, ang topics na nidiscuss na sa pharmacy, may basis na. Okay, may pinanghugutan tayo, kumbaga. And that is where physical pharmacy was born. Okay, because class, physical pharmacy integrates theories and laws in the physical world. Okay, obviously, this involves both physics and chemistry. And apply it, class, to our pharmaceutics. Okay, to our pharmaceuticals. Now, what is physical pharmacy ba? So this course, class, simply involves an analysis of the application of basic physico-chemical principles and methodology. So by definition, class, it's an area of pharmacy that deals with the quantitative and theoretic principle of science as they apply to the practice of pharmacy. So basically, class, yun na nga, application dito, class, would be more on principles regarding physics and chemistry. So combined siya, kumbaga. Now, why is it important, class, that we study physical pharmacy? As you all know, class, for us to be able to use a drug, it must be in its dosage form. Okay, dosage form, class, can either come in the form of tablets, capsules, suspensions, solutions, and so on and so forth. So you have to prepare these things. But whenever, class, we prepare these dosage forms, we have to make sure na stable naman yung dosage form. Aanhin ko ang gamot, class, kung kinabukasan panis agad. Right? So therefore, class, it's important we need to be able to stabilize our drugs. So ibig sabihin, we need to understand its physical properties, both its physical and chemical properties, so that we can assure that the drug will stay long, okay? Kumbaga stable ang gamot natin. At the same time, class, will work its intended effect. Okay, and then furthermore, class, we need to be able to evaluate whether a drug will be effective or not. Okay? So all these things, class, we need to consider. And hence, class, it's important. That's the reason why it's important we study physical pharmacy. Kasi through physical pharmacy, class, naiintindihan natin ano ba yung mga dapat titingnan natin sa isang gamot. Okay? Para malaman na ay gagana to or pwedeng hindi gumana or mabilis masira ang gamot na to because it has this and that properties. Okay? Now, why is physical pharmacy significant? First, class, it attempts to integrate the factual knowledge of pharmacy through the development of broad principles of its own. Secondly, it aids the chemist and pharmacist. Okay, I have to consider this, class, kasi some although in the Philippines, class, sabi nga natin, meron tayong pharmacy law, wherein any pharmaceutical product, basta may compounding ng pharmaceutical product, laging dapat may pharmacist. Okay, naalala ko kasi, class, nagkaroon dito ng debate with the chemist sa kanilang law. Okay, I don't know if you've heard about this, pero kasi, class, ang claim nila is that drug is still a chemical substance, so it falls under our jurisdiction, sabi ng mga chemist, na kami ang kami dapat mag-compound ng gamot. Okay, so we came to an agreement, class, sa dapat it's a collaborative practice, okay? Especially within a manufacturing firm when we start to compound pharmaceutical products. Kumbaga, basta may pharmaceutical product dyan, may gamot, kailangan lagi may pharmacist to make sure na tama ang gamit, okay? And tama yung pagkakakompound sa kanya. So aids the chemist and pharmacist to predict the solubility, stability, compatibility, and biologic action of drug products. And lastly, class, development of new drugs and dosage forms and improve the various modes of administration. So just so you know, class, ha, it could be one of your thesis, pero most likely, aabutan nyo pa naman siguro face-to-face, right? I believe aabutan nyo pa ang face-to-face. Okay, gagraduate kayo na makikita nyo yung laboratory natin. Okay, kasi class, pwede nyo maging thesis gumawa ng bagong dosage form, halimbawa, or validate a existing dosage form. Halimbawa, class, nung kapanahunan ko parang katagal-tagal na, no? Ang kap, ano ba? Siguro mga 10 years ago, unang sumikat class ang nanoparticles. Okay? Doon sumikat yon. So class, obviously, ang daming ginawang research about nanoparticles. Kasi sinubukan nila gumitin ng nanoparticles for so many types of drugs. Like halimbawa, delivering antimicrobials using nanoparticles, ha? Eh, kumbaga, i-integrate ko yung gamot sa, ano mismo, sa nanoparticles. Okay, baka man, nano ako nanoparticles dito, hindi pala ako na, ano? Okay, so class, ang nanoparticles, kasabi nga natin, napakaliit niyan. Okay, para siyang maliliit na capsules. Usually spherical ang kanyang ano, shape. And class, ang property nito is usually it's lipid base. Okay, lipid siya. Bakit lipid? Kasi class, ang goal ng nanoparticles is to deliver directly the drug, kung ano man yung laman niya, it's going to deliver it directly into the cell. Kasi saan ba gawa ang cell natin? So di ba class, ang cell membrane, okay, is made up of lipids. So di ba sabi natin, ang lipids class, like dissolves like. So dahil lipid ang nature ng nanoparticles, hindi siya mahihirapang pumasok sa loob ng cell. Kasi again, it's lipid by nature. Right? Hindi siya magkaka-problem doon. Kasi class, again, one of the rate limiting step with the absorption of any drug into the cell will always be its solubility in terms of its lipophilicity. Eh, kasi class, kung hydrophilic ang gamot mo, ang tendency kasi class is, dahil lipid ang ating cell membrane, ang tendency class, kung yan ay water-soluble, okay, ang nangyayari class is, nare-repel siya. Alright? So, nagkaka-problem tayo ngayon dito. So, again, class, kayo na sabi ko sa inyo, one of the things that you can study pag nag-face-to-face na kayo, okay, or one of the thesis that you can do class is to either make a new dosage form or validate an existing dosage form. So, class, sabi ko sa inyo, ang nanoparticle is one of the newest dosage form then, back 10 years ago. Actually, mas matagal pa ata eh. I'm not that sure. But anyway, class, because if you give kasi a substance that is water-soluble, dahil lipid ang cell membrane natin, ang tendency class, pwede siyang ma-repel. Diba sabi natin, water and lipid, hindi nila gustong isa't isa. Okay? So, tendency class is mag-repel talaga siya. Now, of course, there are ways wherein this water-soluble molecule can still be absorbed into the cell. Okay, pero let's not talk about that for now. Right? May mga paraan tayo na pwedeng gawin dyan. So anyway, class, nanoparticles. Ang gagawin natin is, if you have a drug, okay, for example, this is the drug, integrate mo yan sa loob ng nanoparticle. Right? There are procedures, class, wherein we can use to allow this drug to enter into this nanoparticle. Normally, class, we use sonicators, okay, ultrasonicators. I don't know if you're familiar with that. Ultrasonicators. Okay, it uses sound waves, high-frequency sound waves, class, to allow the lipid membrane to this, ano, atong nanoparticle natin, para ma-destabilize siya. Okay, ibig sabihin, habang nag-destabilize siya, class, bubuka siya, allowing the drug to enter. Tapos, class, i-re-stabilize natin yung nanoparticle na to allow it to encapsulate totally the drug. Ganyan, actually, class, ang ginagawa natin yan sa Pfizer-BioNTech. Okay, wherein yung mRNA, class, ipapasok natin sa loob ng nanoparticle para yung nanoparticle na yon will deliver, kaya siya drug delivery system. Okay, this nanoparticle class will deliver the drug directly into our cell. Right? So in the case class of the mRNA vaccine, which is the Pfizer-BioNTech, so nakakapasok agad siya sa cell using now the ribosomes of the cell to produce the spike proteins of our coronavirus. So amazing, di ba? Isipin niyo paano nila naisip yung mga ganung bagay. Okay, so it only shows class that they have a very good knowledge. The researchers for this, ngayong gumawa ng nanoparticles natin, really had a good background in physical pharmacy. They understood, class, the physical and chemical properties of our compounds, and they were able to manipulate this in a way na nakagawa siya ng bagong dosage form. Okay? Now, malay nyo, class, you'll be the next one to make, ano ba, something new? Okay, bagong dosage form in the near future. Why not? Kaya-kaya niya. Right? So anyway, and lastly, class, development of new drugs and dosage forms, yun na nga yun. Okay, and improve the various modes of administration. So malay nyo, baka mahanap kayo ng bagong paraan wherein we can administer vaccines without actually injecting them. Actually, class, meron na ngayong ginagawang ganyan in the form of a transdermal patch. Did you know that? Okay, alam niyo transdermal patch? Familiar ba kayo sa transdermal patch? Yeah, no? Yes? Ah, okay, not much. Okay. A transdermal patch, class, yun yung, ano ba? Para alam niyo salon pass. Okay, alam niyo yung salon pass. Di ba parang patch na yun na nalagay yes, sa masakit? Right, good. So class, ang transdermal patch parang ganun, pero mas specialized yung kanyang ano form, yung kanyang formulation, yung patch na gamit niya. Okay, yung vaccine kasi pinag-uusapan ko dito is yung transdermal patch may maliliit na needles. Okay? And it will it will administer the antigens or the bacteria, weakened bacteria into your body slowly via those small needles. So ilalagay mo lang dito, halimbawa, patong mo lang diyan. Hayaan mo lang siya diyan class, it's delivering now the vaccine to you.
Sir, in relation po sa napag-uusapan kanina, same lang po ba yun kapag yung may diabetic, mga diabetic people po, parang may ganun po ata sila for insulin, hindi ko po sure, parang dinidikit at may karayom.
Yes, exactly. Actually, meron din yun. Okay, that's another application class of that dosage form. Hindi na siya to deliver vaccine, but also to deliver insulin. Okay, pero nowadays kasi class, another dosage, actually matagal na rin to eh, inhalational. I don't know if you've heard about this, inhalational insulin. Ang kanyang brand name is Exubera. Pero hindi siya sumikat. Exubera. Yan. Exubera, yan yung kanyang brand name. Pero alam ko Pfizer ang gumawa nito if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, it's an inhalational form of insulin. Pero right now, class, nakita nilang maraming problema sa kanya. So they're still trying to modify further that dosage form. Kasi class, ang goal ngayon with insulin is how to administer it without the need of injections. Okay, without need of injections. Kasi one of the things na ayaw ng mga patients, bakit ayaw ng patients gumamit ng insulin? Simply because you have to administer it subcutaneously. Kailangan mo tusukin ang balat. Yes, kailangan mo siyang i-ganun. Tusok-tusok. Okay, hindi mo naman kasi pwede class ibigay ang insulin as oral tablets. Bakit? Kasi ang insulin class is a hormone. It's basically a protein. Alam naman natin class anong meron sa ating GI tract. We have their proteases. Okay, enzymes class that is intended to digest proteins. Nilunok mo pa lang class ang insulin, wala na, sira na agad 'yan. All right? So that's the reason why the only way we can administer it is either parenterally. Right? Kailangan natin i-break yung skin. Eh syempre, sino ba naman ang gusto araw-araw nagsasaksak ng insulin, right? It's a stressful experience. Kahit sabihin natin sanay ka dyan, nakaka-stress pa rin yun. Right? Kaya naghahanap tayo ngayon ng ways to administer insulin without the need of for breaking your skin. So yun nga, example yun, yung transdermal patch na maraming tusok-tusok. Okay, so yun. So those are the significance class of physical pharmacy. So for us to be able to design those things, we need to first understand ano yung kailangan nating i-manipulate. Ano mga kailangan nating i-consider before we can make a dosage form. Right? Now, what about for physical chemistry on the other hand? Kasi magkadikit to eh. Okay? So, physical chemistry class is simply a branch of chemistry concerned with the interactions and transformations of materials. So, basically kasi class, whenever we design dosage forms or whenever we make drugs class, sometimes we have to employ certain chemical reactions to change the structure of our drug to suit our needs. Okay? A good example of this class would say, for example, be the formation of chelates. Okay? Sir, ano ba yung chelates na yan? Actually, we have a separate discussion for this. Okay, pero this is one way class of changing your drug chemically. Chelates class are chemicals designed to encage. Kine-cage niya yung gamot natin. Okay, whatever that substance is that you're going to use. Wherein class, pag kine-cage niya yung substance na yun, it alters its properties class. Chemically, not just physically. It alters the properties of your drugs chemically. Chelates kasi class, a good example of this is dimercaprol. Naintindihan niyo ba yung sinulat ko? Wait lang ha. Dimercaprol. Okay? Dimercaprol class kasi is the antidote, is the general antidote for heavy metal poisoning. Yes. Okay, so antidote for heavy metal poisoning. Okay? So, ibig sabihin ka, halimbawa, nakainom ka ng arsenic or any heavy metals. Alright? Ang gagawin natin sa iyo, class, bibigyan ka usually ng dimercaprol. Right? Ang ginagawa kasi ito, class, it creates chelates. It chelates, class, your heavy metals. Kumbaga, kung ito yung heavy metal ko, kunwari yan, ito yung heavy metal ko, i-cage niya yan, class. Lalagyan niya yan ng cage. Allowing the heavy metal class to become water soluble and easily eliminate from the body. Okay, so it alters class the properties of that heavy metal to allow your body to be able to eliminate this more efficiently. Okay, kasi ang tendency kasi class, pag may heavy metals ka sa katawan mo, it stays for a long period of time in the body. But by giving you a chelating agent, yun, we transform that heavy metal class into something that allows it to become more easily, allows it to become more easily eliminated from the body. Okay, so does that make sense, class? Okay, I hope it makes sense, class. So yun siya, yung chelate na to, class, again, nagki-create siya ng structure around that chemical or your compound of target, yung target mo na chemical. Okay, which allows it to chemically change that, you know, that compound, and therefore, yun, allow it to be its properties will be changed chemically. Right? So that's one way. Yun is sa mga ginagawa na dito, kaya nga pinag-aaralan na dito si physical chemistry. So unlike other branches, class, it deals with the principles of physics underlying all chemical interactions such as gas laws. So huwag kayong magugulat, okay, kung mapag-uusapan natin, class, ang mga, naalala mo yung mga PBNRT, sina Gay-Lussac, sina ano. Okay, pero ano lang, konti-konti lang naman, parang konting review lang. Sabi ni Miss Heidelin, sir, same lang po ba sila ng masking agent? Masking agents kasi, class, no. Normally kasi, class, masking agents like, say, for example, sa dosage form niyo ba ito natutunan? Did you guys learn this from dosage form?
Quality control po, sir.
Ah, okay, sa quality control. Okay. Now, normally kasi, class, what ang ginagawa lang ng masking agents is to, well, simply mask the physical characteristics of your drugs. Okay? Let's say, for example, yun, pwede rin yun, for identification. Okay? So that's true. Kasi, class, if it's chelates, it alters your drugs chemical on a chemical level. Now, ito nga pala, class, ang pinagkaiba ng physical pharmacy. Pag sa our physical characteristics of your drugs. Pag sinabi natin physical characteristics, baguhin mo man yun, siya pa rin yung drug. Okay? Baguhin mo, halimbawa, bigyan ko kayo ng bato. Durugin ko yung bato na yun. At the end of the day, class, bato pa rin yun. Diba? I altered it physically kasi dinurog ko siya, but at the end of the day, it's still a rock. Right? Okay. E class, halimbawa, ang asukal, sugar, sinunog ko. Is it still sugar? Would it still be sugar? Actually, class, it becomes, ang sucrose ko, magiging fructose na yun. So it's already altered chemically. Right? Yun, class, ang pinagkaiba ng physical properties sa chemical properties of our drugs. Physical properties, class, even if I alter this, it's still the same. It still becomes the same. Okay? Pwede lang gumanda yung kanyang absorption, distribution, metabolism, excretion, blah, blah, blah. Alright? So, ganun siya. So, physical properties, class, even if I alter it, it still stays the same. Unlike, class, with chemical properties, it chemically changes the original form of that compound. Okay? Kaya, class, yun ang pag-aaralan natin sa physical pharmacy. Pero actually, we'll be studying more of the physical properties rather than the chemical properties here. Although we'll have to, tawag dito, and we'll still touch on it. Okay, kaya nga may physical chemistry yung ating, ano eh, ating subject na to. Right? ETA, class, yes, ETA is actually a chelating agent. Okay, if you know this, class, it chelates your, ano, clotting factors, especially calcium. Okay, which yes, therefore sir. prevents your blood from clotting. I don't know if you're familiar with this, class, pero kasi calcium is a clotting factor. Right? This one is a clotting factor. So, kumbaga, tinatanggal niya, class, si calcium sa blood mo, allowing your blood not to coagulate. This is actually the clotting factor number 4. Sorry. Okay? Si clotting factor number 4, si calcium. So, ang ginagawa ni EDTA is that it chelates that calcium. Okay, at the same time, dahil kinilate niya yung calcium na yun, inalter niya si calcium. So, wala na kayong calcium ang blood mo. So, tendency is, nahihirapan ngayon mag-coagulate yung dugo mo.